Failure is a natural part of the journey. If you're not failing, you're not trying anything new. My name is Silas Adekunle. I'm a robotics engineer, a robotics entrepreneur. Check me out. I was born in Ibadan, so and then we moved to Osun State. And growing up, you know, the things I loved was wildlife, which we have an abundance of in Nigeria. My mom was a medical nurse, and you know, UK had this outreach program where they were, you know, they had a shortage of nurses and inviting nurses and these types of programs. So, you know, that my mom traveled. We were home with my dad, and then eventually we all went over to go and join her. We all went there. I think we arrived in January. That's winter. It was cold. I remember very well, like growing up and, you know, going to school, and someone's like, "Oh, do you have a cow? Do you ride a cow? You know, do you live in huts?" And I'm just like, "What videos are you guys watching? Where are you getting all these stories from? Like Nigeria's, you have cities. You know, what are you thinking? We grew up going to church and dancing and things like that. That's part of your culture. Over there, things are a lot more calm, toned down. You can't just turn up at someone's house. You have to ring ahead of time. You can't just play in the street. You know, so a few different things. So, you look at all of the positives and you see some of the negatives. I went to university to study robotics. And I was also a big gamer, so I loved gaming. So the things that we were learning about robots, I think, well, this thing is perfect to teach maths and sciences, and it's a lot more exciting than all of the boring stuff that we've been learning. So why don't we use robotics to teach these fundamental principles? And then the thing I did differently was, okay, sometimes robotics can be boring. Well, why don't we add gaming as a layer on top of that? So you're not just building a robot, you're building a video game character that can then, you know, like Mortal Kombat or something that can battle each other, things like that. And then I saw that idea picked up in the classroom. The students were a lot more interested, things like that. It's kids that would normally bully each other, argue, they were a lot more interested. Then I looked around at the toy industry. You know, at the time, it was like, you buy a robot, it's not really a robot. It's not like something that you see in a movie. It's just this thing that just goes, you know, it's very basic. Why can't we take this idea and use it in the you know, toy industry and change the type of toys that people see? Why can't you see something in a movie and say, I want to create that and actually bring it to life? You know, so that was the start of a six-year journey to then create a company called Reach Robotics. Oh, and over the life of the company, you know, raised north of $15 million, was generating millions of revenue. We had a distribution deal with Apple, which is one of the biggest consumer electronics company in the world. Personally, in terms of the journey, that also allowed me to think, look, anything you set your mind to, you can create, you can bring to life. And that was the foundation for, well, you know, why don't we do this on a bigger scale? Why don't we start looking at how we can get robotics onto the African continent, enable robotics on the African continent, which is what now involved in. My name is Silas Adekunle. I'm a robotics entrepreneur, a robotics engineer, and you've just checked me out.